no, the last video was really strong, harsh one. I don't know, attacking the three companies for Vaux habits. I guess it got me over testosterone or something. So right now I don't really want to play car mechanics. That is up to others, up to others in the line of my bloodline. Let that go to other persons. That is really not a happiness spot for me. So that's what we call that. My audition to run car companies. I'm not in the pleasure of. I will definitely give input on the designs and what has happened, though. That was terrible, and I believe that is a good way for some of us. Some of us that are doing many other things is to have a design design committee, so you go and show the designs to the new king of France, show him the designs, and yes, he can make that decision. But I don't actually want him to tinker with every new different part purchase, no matter how excellent he is with the knowledge of. I don't want him to be dealing with that. He has too many other things on his mind. So yeah. Oh my goodness. I've added new informations about the initiation takeover. It is a takeover in a way. It is a changeover, though, from how things are run. To get this prepaid out there to everyone, we have to acquire the properties, and they have to be resold, and we cannot go bankrupt in the middle of it. You cannot have you selling it, and then we have to pay you, because then already we end up bankrupt. We end up bankrupt from that action if we do not have the seller. So it has to be sold also at the very beginning. We have to make an accumulation of, so we have further years of the prepaid wage available. Otherwise, why set it up for 1 year? You cannot run. We cannot run this 1 year at a time. It has to be several years, and it also has to have the accumulation balance also there, of the other departments, and for the infrastructure, the other departments, for the military. It has to have all of these available, all of these different things available to keep things not. In any, like, hey, I didn't get my money, I'm not being able to budget this area of government. All areas of these former have to be supplied to during the transition phase, and we then we are going to go through with a little bit more, what do you call it, precision. Do we really need it, you know? And yes, it does get complicated with the army itself. Those particular properties, any property sold there within the army barracks, if it's selling it into the kingdom, is really ridiculous. I understand though that there may be already persons that want purchase money from it. So we have to understand that may be going on, and in the selling into the kingdom, we will purchase at a very low price, and we will up it. We will up it to turn it into a housing community or whatever. However, in the very low price, the reason for the upage, gain in the income from us as the kingdom, to sell it off to a housing community is not to save it and keep it in that moment. It's actually for the veterans' hospitals. For the other departments of the military also, so it is to be kept. It is to be kept merely as a different type of a property that is not included. It's not included with the other properties of house residential normal. I also instilled a limit. I put a limit out there on 10 million, 10 million, in any currency of the 1-to-1. I do not want to be receiving. I'm still having a problem with the universities because they are much more in price, and I am greedy for them to be in included immediately. However, I may have to retract that. Go to the 10 million, 10 million. If your house is worth 11 million, you are not going to be able to sell it for instant money into our kingdom. Because we're paying you instantly. And so because we are paying you instantly, in that fact, it is a huge amount of money. And so we are needing you to show up with a buyer, or you have to have someone interested that's already known and wanted the house, and they are certain for it, and they will take it. And so that as soon as you go over the 10 million, that is a limit right away, to make sure that we do not go over our budget. Because it really is, it's just a budget. There's just a budget here of the make sure we have the 20 million available to all the persons each year, and support the other facets of government. Yeah, so we don't want to go bankrupt. This is really what it's all about. So I presume the programmers will be putting in the limits, a limit when we get too close. When we're getting too close to, hey, we have not acquired enough savings. And so already there needs to be a limit put there in the program that says, hey, a warning. We have to then go back and even when your house is worth a million, if your house is worth a million, you need to have a buyer, already agreed to buyer, and then we will accept it as through. Otherwise we'll just be left with lots of, there went another million out the window. There went another 10 million, and there went another 100 million. So we have to be careful. It's just a simple bank balance, weight and levy, up and down. It's very simple. But that just a little warning into the system would be required there. Now, certain areas are not going to ever require a warning. Certain areas are never going to require a warning. And the beast on the pasta is right there at the Bay Area. The Bay Area, not all though. I'm saying the East Bay, the east side of the Bay Area, because we have Oakland, we have the Berkeley, we have that Fremont zone. We have areas of people that really want poverty over. They want poverty to finish. They do not want poverty to continue. They are adamant professionals at knowing what poverty is. They want poverty to go away forever. So they are there full-heartedly in that facet, that beauty of group of people. And I cannot say that they exist everywhere. I do not believe not all people even care to stop poverty. And this is the astounding to me also. I am going out there. We're stopping Ethiopia, little baby pubescent belly viewages. We don't want this any longer. We don't want to see the Chad photos of videos. We don't want to be anymore knowing that people are born into this world to die immediately. We do not want this. Now, how other persons would continue and want to keep it, I do not know the consciousness they have upon their pillow at night. I do not know how that is possible. I do not know how they have any conscientiousness of mind, or stability of person, actually. Completely imbalanced. I see them as an imbalanced human being. To walk a world and feel that you are better to live a breath over another. So, emotions aside from it, I have areas of the world that maybe they just do not understand poverty. They will not know what it is to stop it. So right away, I'm already looking at San Francisco. It's like this flippant, like, San Francisco is like, what is San Francisco up to? What is San Francisco actually doing? Are they into our kingdom or not? Are they into actually stopping poverty? I don't even think they know or care. I really do not think they care. So in explaining, because there are many Chinese there, there are many Asians, there are also many persons that are simply just living their San Franciscan life, quite shallow. Now, if those persons, which are not, they're not a great ecologist either. I'm not saying the San Francisco Bay Area is ecology central, only on the east side and into Marin. Thank you, Marin, for your support. I know Marin is there. I know the concept there all the way to the Marin Civic Center. I know those persons are there and they are helpful and they want this over. They want this to be it's finished. We did it. You know, we own the world through property. I'm not gold-backed. I'm not running around trying to grab silver out of a mountain. I'm not doing anything like this. And yes, the Emperor of China there, he's a new emperor. And we have to understand gold. He's flashing his gold out there. Like, hey, look at what I got, you know, it makes me great. And I'm not angry at him at all, but in that moment, we have to realize where we are and our strength. Our strength is every property that is purchased and sold into our kingdom within the lands. And that is how we end poverty. And that is how we continue with strength. So, what was it? Yeah, so explaining to San Francisco. I have come up with other ideas to bring a global community there. I kind of like the cuteness of it because San Francisco is so small and concise. I like the cuteness of bringing in other monarchies and saying, okay, you can have let's split it out on a map even, you know, split it out on a map. But it gets complicated if you start doing this. It gets complicated, doesn't it? Isn't it better to just maintain it as one major kingdom? You know, make that the Kingdom of France right there, all of the San Francisco Bay Area, all the way down to Half Moon Bay. Make it this way to even the Santa Cruz. But, you know, don't go too far, don't want everyone to freak out. But in the same token, if we do take the other monarchies of the world and we say China can be half of San Francisco, down through Daly City, down to the SF airport, we will end up with their weird little China laws, possibly. And they're not necessarily agreeable to American lifestyle and their community. So that it's not that's a type of a takeover. I'm not trying to say, okay, you know, go ahead and instill what you are doing as your emperor status, because it may be so different. And then there's Britain. Where is Britain? You know, Britain gets the other half from Pacifica all the way through to the Half Moon Bay. That would be perhaps for Britain. And so I have to decide, you know, these types of, it's a beautiful gift to go ahead and say, you can have this part of it, and that part of it, and that part of it, and we have our monarchy eight, or whatever you want to call us, our little beautiful royal families there, able to look at this property world design. And just realize that right there and right then, owning all of it, and doing the same within each one of our countries around the world, is the end of poverty. And also the inclusion of much business, much enterprise, without the heady taxes of income, the business incomes and the personal incomes associated. Now, I have not made a blog specifically about gambling income tax. Now, the gambler societies of the world there in Vegas and those, they will have to, as gaming halls, they will have to have to pay us additional. And I'm going with 25% yearly on their income. So they will be the only ones I can see right now that have to pay a yearly income. That will be the gaming halls and institutions. Gambling, anything to do with gambling. Yes, it's a beautiful idea, isn't it? The sovereignty of San Francisco states, the states of sovereign. It is a beautiful idea, and it is a great idea. I know it. We're looking at San Francisco Airport, though, handled by the Chinese, and that might be a little difficult. And I don't believe China wants to purchase all of the buildings, the skyscrapers of San Francisco. It's quite a danger to go in there and say, I'm going to purchase all the skyscrapers unless I have a buyer. I would have to have a buyer for each. And that could be already all of his gold there he has in his pile. So he's not wanting maybe that effort. He's already probably smartly looking at this preference to go slow with us as we are doing. Go slow and take only the 10 million in value properties as a limit. But I would not be headily running into skyscraper ownages unless you have a buyer for that huge I don't know, what are they, 200,000-300,000 often in the millions. So you're gonna need to have a buyer. If it is a university also, or I don't want our universities to all be parsed out. I don't want them all parsed out to you know, the guy down the road purchased the alumni house or the Phi Beta Kappa. But you can do it. You can do this also. You can have that version. It's okay to have a cooperatively owned university, and yet it is still run as the several. The several in a group, a coalition of owners. It is a possible, and so I'm still wanting to purchase the universities to go in that direction. However, it can get eclectic. It can get extremely eclectic when you have owner A over there in that department of the music department, and he does not ever want to update his instruments, and then you have over there in the football department someone who just spends so much money on their football and their sports department that their instrument department just shrinks, and then the one over here that's the English department is very sad and angry because they are mainly known for literature and music, and somehow they became a massive sports department. So you end up with these types of fights as soon as we go in that direction. And if the university is up for it, if there is a vote that the university is up for it to be parted out, we have to go ahead and allow them that to be sold into the kingdom. So I'm also I'm discluding though yachts. I'm discluding yachts, and yes, I know they are homes. I know there are massive houseboats out there that are also homes, but I am discluding them right now, simply because they are not an instant purchase. They are not something that is always known, and often there is. You have to take the steel tap at the side and do all this extra examination, and it's just too much. It's too much. The boat thing I'm leaving out. Maybe we'll do that later. Firstly, foremost, it will be the normal condominiums, apartments, and houses, and like that. So I think that's enough. Did I make it clear that the support is your, if your community, if your, you can say with full gain that yes, Los Altos can be involved in into the owner property world and go with it. Well then yes, and if you have enough support, we will start to think, well, do I need to realize that maybe the one next door, the communities next door, El Camino or whatever, are not full support, simply because of education, simply because they will not understand it. They're not going to understand what I'm talking about, the Redwood City. They're not understanding it. And Stanford, perhaps, persons and around there in those neighborhoods will. So we have these outcroppings, and the Hillsboroughs will. They are understanding it, and yes, they want it. Anything. I mean, it's just like ridiculous. You know, finally a stop to it. And also, yet able to maintain their incomes. Able to maintain their incomes and have many free workers that also support the business, that are there to receive a little bit of savings also. So many businesses will be owned in joint coordination. You'll have the 10, let's say 10 employees, and you have two or three major owners. So you can have the two or three major owners that have the $150,000 each that they have put toward the business, and then you have the little tiny income of the $30,000 a year with your employees. However, you don't have to pay the employees any longer. They are simply requesting the profits, a little bit of the profits. And so you'll get your profit from your 150 input, and they will get their profit from their 3,000 input. And that's the way it goes. And what was the next thing that was way cool? Oh my gosh, it has greatness. It's the greatest little plan. I can't believe I actually finished it so many years ago, and it has not been taken up for grabs. I feel because it has not been taken up for grabs that the people are in some kind of a disillusion, possibly entering into accessories to murder, because it is an accessory to murder, to kill persons through that are impoverished. It is a murder. Because money was able to be supplied and yet not given. So because I've come up with this over 3 years ago, moment of silence for many of you. All right, so yeah, so you're gonna have these little smart soul communities that understand an economic change, an economic revolution, yet one that is safe, one that is sustainable, one that is on a world scale for all of the countries on the planet, one that is not an interrupter. Rather a new beginning to more education for persons young. There was something else great with the business. There was something else great. I wrote it there on the blog, though, but it has two great things. It was a big worry of the high-priced communities. If you're the high-priced community and you have like this $1.5 million home, and you're like, okay, there's only two persons there, and let's say you have the $5,000 you must pay every month. So you're looking at the $60,000 per year. we, as this new kingdom, are only going to give each one of you 20,000, and you can only apply 10,000 each toward that home. So you need to come up with the 40,000 yourself. Now, to come up with the 40,000 yourself, you're going to have to either include another roommate person who wants to also be an owner to it, and they would be an owner. And so that would be 30,000. So you're like, well, maybe I'll do that. And then I'm thinking, maybe not. So they're a mom-and-pop style business. Okay, they're entrepreneurs there, let's say they're in the Bay Area. They need to come up with 40,000 extra to pay off their original bank loan. I'm not canceling their original bank loan. They have decided not to sell. They want to stay in the house. All right. So they're staying in the house, they're still paying the old bank. The 40,000 has to come off from their work, from what they are doing with their work. They still have the bonus though, that they are getting now free teachers if they are in some kind of a club or sports assistants, or they're getting free workers to be in their restaurant. They're getting these types of supply. So they don't have to pay the wages any longer. So now their business is making additional money, and they do not have to pay the business income tax. Because they do not have to pay the business income tax, and they also have to not pay the wages, it is like, oh my goodness, they have much more money freed up than in their profits. And those profits will help to pay the house. So there you go. I guess that was the big scare, was for those persons that have just huge bills to pay from the mortgage, and yet they want to still maintain their house and not sell it. So for them, they stay with the bank, the old banks, and there'll be persons that will want to stay with the old banks for the next 20 years and not want to sell. They just want to stay there. I am not kicking old banks out. They may be conglomerating and merging over time, but I'm not kicking them out of business. They will still be able to offer loans on houses that are more. Let's say you are getting already the 20,000 each, and you've decided, well, you're going to wait a few weeks and then you can go out to restaurants and then shop a little extra. Well, if you're that type of person that doesn't spend every day and can hold your funds for a while, you can live off that 10,000 throughout the year, yes. So however, now you're like, okay, well, I need the extra money. I need the extra money to pay, because the house I really wanted was a little bit more. And so then you do go to the old bank. You go to the old bank and ask for that loan. Go ahead if that is your way. But from us, there is zero. We are not charging you interest. We are actually giving you the free money. There is no interest, and it is the free money. So it's up to you if you want to pay the interest rate with the old banks, and say, I want a house worth the 600,000 or the 800,000 when it is out of my league, given freely through us, through our kingdom. So I believe it all works. I believe it all works. You just have to, you're gonna have to do that type of math yourself. That type of math you have to do yourself. So now we're just waiting. We're clapping our hands and waiting for universities around the world to write this bank and have it active for larger areas. And I feel it is already done. You know, I feel it is already done. It is that amazing. And I'm not, I have to reiterate, I'm not taking your kingdoms away. I'm not trying to take the emperor of China's emperor status away. Good gosh, no. Good gosh, no. Much better to talk to one emperor than the emperor and his kind of if he has a group of special interest persons. I'm much more preferred to talk to the person who is running the people, who is actually in charge of the people. All right. So, yeah, so we're seeking out monarchies everywhere, and that is our big uplift. I also added a blog concerning road races. I'm beginning road races in the East Bay on the bridge. Now, the road races will bring in money and to the kingdom. And I say money to the kingdom, you have to remember that is money to the people also. So be smiling when I say money into the kingdom. Yes, it's money into our future substantiability and strength. I don't believe we're wanting to be the strength of army so much. We are more the strong and strength of political voices. Political voices that are listened. Yes, we are listening. We are listening to your forums out there. I am listening to what the persons are wanting. That accumulation of listen, rather than a one business being a swayer of a kingdom, rather than one or two businesses being a swayer of a president in the signing of go to war. So in keeping the trilateral, I'll call it the House of Congress, the House of Representatives, and the President, think of them that way as a triangle that has been turned on its side on the ground, and the monarchy, the kingdom, the central bank, the kingdom de Vaux here of France, being the one that receives suggestions from that group. And over time we will reduce that group. They are way too large. Over time we will reduce that group. Way too many representatives here, there, and everywhere. Hopefully by half. But no, we're not doing away with judiciary system either. The judiciary system has been working, aside from the big fights over murder death row zones. Yes, I believe already the San Quentin prison is included with this particular land space gain of the kingdom. I already have requirements for splitting out who is there. If they are murder, they stay. If they are white collar crime, they will go elsewhere and we will figure out some reform. If they are drug sales, they will go elsewhere and we will figure out some other kind of reform. So I really only want the murderers in there. Now the next would be if they are involved in the drug capacity, was the reason for being put in there, was too many drug sales or something. It's possible they can be used to help with the legality of. We have many that are being legalized. We have legalized medically. Medically legal. We have opiates and we have also the marijuana. So we are thinking of these particular two being used and they can perhaps, if that is their forte, be helpful in that reform, and used as little shops. We can have them as little shops similar to Holland. And use them as keepers of the little shops. So they may be reformed that way, in areas that we are not sure we wanted, but it would be apotheca type, which means like little drug stores, and they would be limited to who they give it to. So there will be a little bit of trust involved. However, it seems like an odd thing to do, to give them little shops, but it seems like that is their interest. So this is it, their interest. Well, perhaps they become business added there also. So going there with the medical marijuana's and having help there, delivering to certain persons, and this will all be done highly digitally, house to house. When the house, the person is on order 6 to 8 months out, they receive their orders on purchase, and it is a medical order, and the courier will have courier services then to them, and these will all be official, and they will be keepers of these drug stores, and they will also be in sync with the police. Police also will be working in these businesses, so they will be working hand in hand with the police as businessmen, side by side. So that's the way it goes. And what else? I guess that's it for now. I don't know, the murder is in there and all that death row business, it really gets tedious. I can't talk of it right now. I'm too just, we're not buying skyscrapers full out by one business organization. If the skyscraper is office buildings that they have already been parted out, this office is worth $30,000, and this one over there is $100,000, and it's by many, many, many owners, then you can sell. Then you can sell it into the kingdom. But not the entire skyscraper and the buildings, the little rooms inside, not the entire skyscraper. All right.